All right, what is going on, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to the one and only Wrestling Otaku channel, of course, your personification of excellence on YouTube and YWC, and I'm back here on the channel. It is now officially late Monday, March the 25th of 2024, so I wanted to go ahead and do this video here because I did say I want to do more content on the channel, and there's a specific news story that I caught wind of a little while ago that I just really felt the need to talk about here, and that's what I wanted to do on the channel, get my thoughts on these wrestling news stories and all that kind of stuff, and more content coming, like I said. Next wrestling review will be, of course, this Wednesday's Dynamite, and then shortly after that, at some point in April, which is in another week from now, we've got, again, less than the week left in the month of March here. So in April, I'll be bringing back the World of Wrestling podcast. You guys will be seeing that right here on the channel. So be sure, if you haven't already, to subscribe to the channel, like this video, share this content, tell your friends, tell everybody you know to subscribe to the Wrestling Otaku channel. So that being said, let's get into it here. So the topic of this video is going to be one specific individual who, in the past, I haven't necessarily had a, shall we say, a very high opinion of, just based on things that I've seen of her. But in recent, and right at least in light of recent events, I've grown to have a newfound, kind of a different opinion, kind of a different take on her as a person. And the individual I'm going to be talking about today is Ronda Rousey. You see, Ronda Rousey was recently in the news. There was a big news story in regards to her, in regards to remarks that she made towards her former, I guess you could say, former employer, that being WWE, and specifically the people within WWE. So, if you guys have been familiar with videos I've done in the past on my old channel when it comes to Ronda Rousey, like I said before, she wasn't exactly my cup of tea. Like, I didn't particularly care much for her. Like, just not necessarily as a talent, as a wrestler. She was okay, like, when she first came into WWE. She was all right, you know. She did all things considered, you know, even though she was, again, relative newcomer to the wrestling. Obviously, she was, you know, had a background in mixed martial arts, MMA, came from UFC. That's where she made her name. And coming over to the wrestling scene, she did well. She performed well in her first stint. Then she came back, and it was kind of like, kind of a lukewarm kind of thing. And then my opinion on her kind of soured with various remarks she made about wrestling and the fan base and stuff like that. And so that's kind of where a lot of my takes in the past have kind of been drawn off of. I called her, you know, she came off as a little selfish, a little, you know, self-serving. I did call her, you know, a bitch or bitchy at times. And again, just based on things I've seen of her. But recently, she took to basically describing or basically explaining her issues with WWE, specifically with Vince McMahon and all the people who worked under Vince McMahon or worked under Vince McMahon in terms of the people who ran that company. And she divulged all this both in something that she is coming out with very soon, a book or a memoir, as was reported. And also she had an interview recently where she spoke on her issues with WWE. And hearing her basically tear WWE a new asshole pretty much verbally brings me great joy. And quite frankly, it's something to celebrate. It's something to give praise to. So she was quoted. She was interviewed recently by Cage Side Seats. And she was talking about her last run in WWE and her problems with Vince McMahon. She also has a, like I said, a book or a memoir that she's coming out with. It hasn't come out yet, but some excerpts from that book have been leaked, I guess, on the internet. And this has been making the rounds here in terms of the wrestling news. And she's basically gone on to grill WWE, grill Vince McMahon, and so on and so forth, basically blasting him, calling him a, you know, 80-year-old, you know, fucking creep or sicko or something like that. And basically, you know, getting very, obviously gets very in-depth with her disdain for the people who ran WWE during her time there. You know, specifically, she points out Bruce Pritchard. She specifically hates Bruce Pritchard with a passion, which is a sentiment that I'm sure is shared by a lot of talents in that locker room, especially on the women's side. And she basically divulges a situation between Bruce Pritchard and a former talent by the name of Aaliyah. Of course, I remember, you know, when I was covering WWE. Of course, I remember Aaliyah for the most part. She was, you know, obviously very young, very green, you know. I mean, she was good looking. She was attractive. She was cute and all that. You know, she had the look. She was decent looking, but she couldn't wrestle worth a damn. You know, so that's partly why I never really cared for her. But Ronda Rousey basically tells the story in this interview. And I believe this is part of her book, you know, an excerpt from her book as well, where basically there's a situation where Bruce Pritchard pretty much told Aaliyah that, you know, she's a waste, nobody wants to work with her, blah, 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 and she was, like, in tears or whatever, and it was a situation backstage with some other talents, and then Ronda Rousey got involved, and they all went to Bruce Pritchard and basically confronted him, and he basically, you know, because Ronda Rousey was there, he basically bucked up, and he acted all, you know, all courteous, and like, oh, no, you know, we didn't say that, or I don't know who said that, blah, 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 basically, you know, yucking it up, sucking up, because unlike with other women's talents, he couldn't just, you know, assert his authority with someone like Ronda Rousey, because Ronda Rousey didn't put up with that shit, you know, and she basically made it known that she wasn't going to put up with Bruce Pritchard's bullshit. She wasn't going to put up with anybody, you know, telling her what to do or trying to force her hand or something, you know, so on and so forth, because unlike with the other talents in that locker room, especially in the women's side, Ronda Rousey actually had some pull, actually had some influence, because she was not made by WWE. She was not created. You know, WWE did not make her. She made her own name outside of WWE before she ever set foot in that company. She has major mainstream name value in the sports and fighting world, in the MMA world, from being in UFC for all those years. That's where she made her name. And then she came to WWE later because, you know, she wanted to, I guess, fulfill a lifelong dream of being a pro wrestler, and on top of that, the money too. So, you know, obviously that goes into it. That goes into it. Fucking everybody who goes to WWE, money. But Ronda Rousey was the sort of talent and individual where she wasn't going to take no BS from anybody. She had pull, she had stroke backstage, and so she basically used that and asserted her own pull and asserted her own stroke in the situation with Bruce Pritchard. And so shortly after that, apparently Aaliyah was, you know, she was injured, and then, she, you know, she was let go about a year or so after, whatever the case may be. But she basically tells a story of, she basically tells how disappointed she was with the direction in terms of the women's division. And she was actively speaking out about her issues with the way the women's division was ran in that company. And basically saying that Bruce Pritchard and John Laurinaitis and all these fucking people who are in charge, who run these shows, they don't give two shits about the women's division. If it wasn't for Ronda Rousey being there, then there wouldn't have been a women's WrestleMania main event. You know, back when Becky Lynch and Ronda Rousey, who was the champion, Charlotte Flair, you know, that triple threat main event at WrestleMania a couple years ago. There would have never been that had Ronda Rousey never been there. So Ronda Rousey used her pull and her influence to make that happen and to make that women's revolution happen to a certain degree, you know? And so she basically explains in this interview and in these excerpts her problems or her issues with Vince McMahon and Bruce Pritchard and everybody, you know, backstage. She basically says that she can't stand them. And, you know, she more or less, and you guys can see the interview, you guys can probably go and see it for yourself. You can, you know, the news article's up, you know, her excerpts, you know, quotes from her excerpts are up. You guys can read it for yourself. But yeah, so Ronda Rousey really, really, and I mean really digs deep into WWE. And she basically says in so many words that she has no intention of ever going back there. And for that, and for everything that she stated in this interview and in previous statements she's made, basically putting the company on blast, putting it out there what these motherfuckers were doing behind the scenes, and for everything that she's saying and for going out there and putting all that out there for everybody to hear, I have a newfound respect for Ronda Rousey. I really do. That deserves a round of applause. That deserves a round of applause, dude. Ronda Rousey has earned my respect with her recent work, with her recent actions. With all this stuff, you know, that is coming out about Vince and, you know, this big scandal, which is still ongoing. You know, there's still an investigation ongoing. Okay, the Janelle Grant thing was just one incident. There are more incidences besides that. And let's not forget, Ashley Mazar. You got the Ashley Mazar situation, and you got a whole bunch of other situations that I'm sure are going to come out. So basically Ronda Rousey is giving her perspective from when she was in that company, and she was voicing her displeasure with that company even when she was there, because she couldn't do that, because she knew WWE wasn't going to do a damn thing to her, because unlike with the other talents that they were fucking holding down in that women's division, she had a name for herself. She wasn't going to put up with that BS. So props to her. Good on her for doing that shit, man. Good on her for putting this fucking company on blast. Good on her for putting Vince McMahon and Bruce Pritchard and all these fucking stuck-up pieces of shit, snobby fucking motherfuckers in this fucking business, in this fucking company, on blast publicly in this way. And I personally wish more talents would do this. I personally wish more people who no longer work in that company would come out and speak on what this motherfucker's been doing for all these years. What this company has been doing for all these years. And I understand why they don't, because they're afraid of, you know, obviously retaliation, you know, job security, because some of them might want to go back there for whatever fucking reason. I have no idea, but I just wish more people would do this. And Ronda Rousey, she deserves the utmost respect for doing what she's doing right now. She has earned my respect. She has earned my respect. I'm saying that right here and now. I have the utmost respect for Ronda Rousey for doing what she's doing, putting it all on her shoulders and coming out and speaking the truth on these motherfuckers, man. So more and more of that needs to happen. You see, what these motherfuckers in this goddamn community and in this goddamn fucking WWE fan base, these Muppets, need to understand is this company is not the fucking land of milk and honey that you all think it is or that you thought it was for all these years. These motherfuckers are corrupt, they are foul, they are dirty, evil, conniving pieces of garbage who need to be fucking exposed. And the more that Ronda Rousey and other people come out and expose them, the fucking better. My problem has never, let me state this before I close this out, my problem has never been with the talents. My problem has never been with the pro wrestlers. It has always, always, always been the fucking company itself. Specifically, the people who run that dirtbag company. Vince, Bruce Pritchard, John Laurinaitis, Nick Khan, if he's fucking involved, Kevin Dunn, forgot to throw him in that fucking list. Every single one of these fucking executives, every single one of these motherfuckers. You can throw Mark Carano on there too. I made a video about him not too long ago. All these motherfuckers need to be called out. All of them need to be put on blast, and all of them need to suffer the consequences. And I hope TKO does the fucking job. I hope Endeavor does the fucking job. I really do. I really do. There does need to be a house clean. And I don't know if Paul Levesque, aka Triple H, is responsible for any of that, or he knew about any of this. I don't know, man. I'm not going to make that call. I'm sure Stephanie, you know, the reason why Stephanie's not there is because she knew, you know, the shit that was going on, and she didn't want anything to do with it. That's why she left. So there does need to be a fucking house cleaning. And I'm good on Ronda Rousey, man. Good on Ronda Rousey for exposing the shit. Good on her for doing that. That is a true, true fucking soldier. That is a true, true, true top woman. That is a true boss. That is a true fucking boss. That is a true boss woman right there. So I got to give her props, man. I got to give her props for that. So that's pretty much all I got to say for that. So like I said before, the article is up now. There's a bunch of, you know, different wrestling news sites that are covering this. I'm not sure if her book, you know, where she quotes this, or where the stuff is quoted is, I think they said it wasn't released yet. But again, the news story's out there. So you can just, you know, you can go on any wrestling news site and pick it up, you know, where you hear what Ronda Rousey basically said about WWE and about Vince and about Bruce Pritchard and all this. So, and a couple of her wrestling content, you know, creator channels have basically gave their thought about this. I heard Solo Monster gave his thoughts on this. You know, JD, I believe, made a video on it, whatever the case may be. So yeah, man, so it's out there, so you guys can watch, you guys can go check it out if you so choose. But again, good on Ronda Rousey. She has my respect from this moment on. From this point on, Ronda Rousey is a true soldier. She's a true trooper. She's a true trooper, man. She's a real woman. She is a true boss woman, so I gotta give her props for that. Major props for that. But anyway, that's all I gotta say for this video, so thanks for watching here. That's all I got for this one. I got some more wrestling news, topics, wrestling news stories I want to get my thoughts on. When I do, I'm going to come back here on the channel, obviously, give you guys more content. Like I said, wrestling reviews are going to be weekly. Try to be as consistent as possible with those. Next one is going to be Wednesday after Dynamite, and you'll be seeing that right here. But anyway, so that's pretty much all I got to say for that, man. So thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to hit the like button. Greatly helps out the video, helps out the channel. Be sure to leave a comment. Give me your thoughts on this story. If you guys have been following the story, if you read about the story, if you know about it, give me your thoughts. Let me know. Hit me up in the comments, all that engagement, all that kind of stuff. And be sure to subscribe to the channel, man, if you haven't already. Appreciate all the support you can get. We are very close to hitting 200 subs here on the channel. If we can get to that by the end of the week or going into next month, whatever case may be, that would be great. And my goal for the end of the year, I would love to get to 1,000, but, you know, I want to do it, you know, little by little. I know it's, you know, it's not going to happen all at once, you know, but baby steps, you know, baby steps. But yeah, 200 subs, if we can get there by the end of next week, or let's say, that would be great. That would be much appreciated. So be sure to subscribe to the channel. Be sure to hit the bell next to the notification bell next to the subscribe button to be notified of all my future uploads, because if you don't, you're going to be missing out on some good content. But anyway, that's all I got to say for this video. So thank you all for watching. Have a good rest of your night. And I'll see you guys in the next one. But till then, Wrestling Otaku signing out here, and I'm out, guys. See you all later. Peace. Hello, folks. I thank you all for watching this video. Certainly hope you enjoyed the content. I salute you. So if you did enjoy it, be sure to check out all of my other videos on the channel. And as always, be sure to subscribe to the Wrestling Otaku channel for more excellent content, courtesy of the best in the IWC and YWC. Have a good one, ladies and gentlemen.